Oh man. Why is he
you're cutting in and out. I don't know if it's me or you.
I'm cutting in and out. Oh god. Okay. Hold on.
I think you're fine.
I'm gonna change it to the 5G. Okay, am I back?
You're back. One thing I need you to do is on your volume, just turn it down just a smidge, just a smidge. You haven't touched it since the last recording, right?
I just turned it up. Is that good?
When?
Just now.
Okay. That's good.
Right there?
Yeah, that's good.
Okay.
How's mine sound?
Good.
Okay. All right. Welcome back to the Kinks and Beauty Podcast. I am Brittany Okike, and I have the lovely Jessica Houston with me today again.
Hi.
I don't know why I'm saying again. She's my co-host, so.
I'm here every week. Forever. I'm not going anywhere. Hello. Hi.
Hi, everyone. Today, we are talking braids. A Woo-hoo. Black girl's favorite. Thing.
We love a good braid. A good set of braids changes lives.
Oh my gosh. It will change your mood, your week, your day. Like, okay, so we're talking braids because Jess and I both have braids. And I got my braids done yesterday. And I don't know if this happens to you, Jess, but when you get like a fire hairstyle and you go to sleep at night and then you wake up and then you remember you got a good hairstyle and then you're like, oh, my day's already better.
It's already better.
So I woke up this morning forgetting that I had braids and then remembering, and I just had a smile on my face. I like hopped out of bed. It's just that
it's like I don't have to do all this.
You don't have to
shit.
Think about. Right. Yes. Exactly.
You take and that so, bun it off.
Girl. And you're instantly ready. You ready. Instantly have a look. So we love braids. We're talking all things braids today. So yeah, let's start off with your week, Jess. How's your week been? What's anything new?
Nothing new. Okay. We're getting into fall. So, you know, we're changing seasons, which changes moods. I love fall. Fall is like one of my favorite seasons. So other than that, you know, just working.
Yeah, the weather definitely changed on us over the past couple of days. I mean, what was it? A few weeks ago, we had a heat wave waking up to 100 degree weather.
Literally in the valley, going outside. So and it's.
It got to like 110. It was absolutely
brutal.
Horrible. And then now this week, we're waking up to like 50, 60s. It's definitely fall vibes, cuffing
so
season.
Cozy.
I love fall. Pumpkin spice. Are you a pumpkin fan?
No. Mm-mm.
Okay, me neither.
They have an apple one. That they're trying, and I don't really know how I feel.
Really?
About
I love
it.
Apple. Is it like, does it have like apple pie flavors, like cinnamon apple?
But in coffee? I can understand the pumpkin spice in a coffee. I feel like those
right.
two go together.
But does it go together because that's what it's always been? I mean, if we try the apple spice, that's like apple cider, which.
But in a tea,
amazing.
Though, I feel like apple goes great in like an apple cider tea or I don't know. I just feel I have a very sensitive stomach and that just sounds like death to my stomach. So I'm going to let you try it and you tell me.
I'm going to try it. I'll let you know. I mean, I didn't know that. So I'm excited.
Yeah.
I'll definitely try the apple versus the pumpkin. I'm not a huge pumpkin fan at all, actually. I know we got, I got a lot of, people concerned about our podcast last week, checking on me to make sure my face is still intact. Everyone, it's okay. The swelling went down. I'm actually, my skin is actually coming out. It's starting to get a glow, if you will. I've been taking pictures every day just to kind of document everything. And I think it's working. It's not too bad.
I noticed it yesterday. I was like, her skin looks really good. I did.
Okay, that makes me feel good.
I was like, it looks, it's healing great. It doesn't look like, oh Lord. somebody was in my DMs and they were like, we need the pictures. And I was like, y'all, I don't know if you want the pictures.
I cannot. I feel like if I release the picture, it will go viral and it won't be good. Like, publicity is good publicity. No, I don't think, just for the dermatologist, right? Because she's right, great, and it wasn't her fault. So yeah. I'm like, let me just I'll save it for now. So that's the other big question. It's like, can I get another one? Because it's a series of 3 to 4 treatments. And, you know, I mean, I'm willing to sacrifice it all if it's going to work and give me the results I need. But I don't know if she's willing to perform it again. I might have to try someone else. We'll see. We'll cross that bridge when we get there. In a few more weeks.
The fact that you said, one, sacrifice it all, and two, that you just for beautiful, goes on to somebody else. Skin.
So far so good, you guys. Okay, Jess, let's jump into braids. Let's tell the people what we have in our head. We haven't done what's in your hair in a while, but let's talk about it. So like I said, I got some braids yesterday. I got box braids. I love box braids. That's my go-to. I've recently, and I say recently, over the past like year and a half, been doing large braids, large boxes, large braids. I can explain that in a minute, but that's like my go-to right now. I've been doing braids for a very long time and kind of recycled styles over the years, tried new styles, and I'm loving the large or jumbo, depending on the braider, really. But I'm loving this style, and I do waist length. So they're waist length, they're large / jumbo, big boxes. And I like to experiment with color. So I'm having a blonde moment in a few peekaboo shades. So I have like 27 majority throughout my hair. And then I have 613, which is like platinum blonde, two 613 braids, a little peekaboo, and then a reddish, brownish, blondish color, which is the 30. Just what you got?
So I also have box braids. My size is a medium, right? I've made the size up. It's the best way for me to explain to the braider what I want. They can't be too small, because if they're too small, my hair just, I don't like how it too small looks on me. That's just me.
Really?
And then I don't like.
I thought you were going to say you don't like taking them out, but you just don't like how they look.
That too, but I just don't like how they look on me. And then they can't be too large, because my hair is so fine that within 2 weeks of me having braids, my hair starts to come out and I have to take the braids out quicker than what I would like. Side note, Brittany likes the fuzzy once her braids are like worn a little bit.
I like it.
I don't like it. I don't. It doesn't. I don't.
But
like
that's.
It.
I mean, that's just your aesthetic anyway. Because that's even that's true for your natural hair when you wear your
curly
curls.
Hair. Like,
just as curls have to be perfect, they have to be juicy. They have to be defined, well formed. On the other hand, like my favorite wash day is like day three after a wash and go.
I never make it to day three.
Jess is always like washing her hair and rewashing.
I wash my hair like every 2 days. I can do 2 days with curly hair, and then by the third day, we're doing some space buns or a messy bun. We're doing something else because I can't have it out. Like, it's just not.
How long do you have it yours?
My braids.
Yeah, how long?
My braids are always mid back. I am a short girl. Brittany is a tall girl. So she can go waist length. If I'm going waist length, if you go to Beauty Bee's website. IG or website. That's me flipping my hair in the ocean. That was for my 30th birthday. Shout out. That was a great picture.
Amazing.
But that was when I went waist length, because I was going on vacation. It was my 30th birthday. But usually on the everyday, I couldn't have all the hair. It's too much. It takes over. So I do a smooth mid back. And I don't play with color a lot. I've played with color like maybe twice.
Yeah, I remember you were telling me, she was like, oh, I went blonde. And I'm like, where? And you probably used like one pack of 27 in your entire hair. And I was just like, girl, bye. I did not like it.
I didn't like it. I didn't like it. I was like, it's so random. It was very random.
It was cute though. You just have to get used to it.
It was cute.
I feel like it was just a baby step though. It wasn't like, I'm blonde. Yeah. No. I'm flirting with one.
When we go on a vacation next summer, then I might do something different. I might try some like goddess something. I really do want to try goddess, but it take too long. And I don't know what the maintenance on that is.
It's actually not bad.
Really? I'll try.
Yeah, I think it just like, well, we'll talk about that later. But I think you just like mousse it, put some mousse on it every few days or once a week or something. But let's get into it. I love the jumbo braids because one thing that I think it's a main complaint from everyone who gets braids is your edges, right? Mm-hmm. Edges mean the world to Black girls. We must have them. If we don't have them, it's embarrassing. It's catastrophic. And we're always trying to protect our edges, even with our protective styles, because braids are considered a protective style. So for me, my edges are very delicate. I have had them snatched and snatched out, and it was not fun. But luckily for me, I don't have the traction alopecia. So when I do have moments where my edges are thinning out, I try to not manipulate them as much. I don't braid my hair at all, actually. I definitely like use my hair growth oils, massage them. I really, really try to take care of them. And so over the years I've found, over the past couple of years, since I've been doing the jumbo box braids, I found that they're not hard on my edges at all. I don't know if you can see, but like my edges aren't really braided down. They're kind of like slick back. And so I think that's helped me with my hairline and the braids. So that's kind of why I've been so hooked onto large jumbo braids, because the section that they're braiding, like the box, is enough hair to where you're not causing tension on the scalp. And so I think that's kind of what's helping, because the boxes are so big. And although the braids are heavy, kind of, it's not creating as much tension on my hair as would a small box with a little piece of hair carrying a long, heavy braid. So that's kind of why I've chosen to stick with the jumbo large box braid style.
I think, excuse me, I think when you're having a consultation with your braider, talking about edges and like the back of your hair is kind of important, because absolutely, once you take your braids out, if you don't got no hair in the front or the back, the grow back stage after braids is one, it's difficult. And if you're trying to focus on getting your hair back to its natural state and grow back your edges. So that's once tough. My braiders start getting to the front of my head, and I've low-key had to start saying something about the back, too, because the past couple of times that I've had braids, they were too low in the, like, they were trying to get this little nape hair. You can leave the nape hair alone. Right. Just leave it alone. And if it comes out, because when I lay my edges when I have braids, I do the front and the back. I have to do the back too. So now I'm like, oh, you don't have to braid it that tight because I want my edges to stay. And luckily I haven't had a catastrophic braid experience since the braids that I initially moved back to California with. Oh my God, that was the worst set of braids I think I've ever had in my life.
Really?
It was really bad.
Okay, let's talk about it, because I have a story too. So what happened?
Okay, so one, she braided too tight. Like, when you go home after a box braid appointment, I think we should rewind a little bit more. There's a difference between traditional braid knots and knotless.
Yes.
Knotless works better on my hair because it's finer. And it basically gives your hair more room to grow, and it's not giving a lot of tension on your scalp.
And it's more natural looking too.
And it's more natural looking. The braids lay flatter to your head versus if you have the traditional knots, it's thicker.
It sticks up. It doesn't lay as natural as you like it to lay. And it's tighter. It pulls your head. Especially the girls with the good grip.
Oh my God. I think the last time, my Jamaica braids, those were the last time that I got traditional knots, and I could not, I was in pain. Like,
really?
I was in pain. My Jamaica braids, that first night, I laid in the bed. I went to the couch. I took an Advil. Alexis was looking at me like, you gonna be all right? I don't know. But my Jamaica braids, the tension was just too tight. But the braids that I moved back to California with, they were too tight. And she used Expressions Hair. Expressions Hair doesn't do well on my hair. I don't know if it's something about how coarse it is, or I don't know if it was that mixed with how tight the braids were. But when I took those braids out, I did not have a lick of hair.
Really? I didn't know that. Where? And that your edges or the nape of your head?
Everything.
Really?
My hair thinned out.
It thinned out. Wow.
Yep. So that was part of the reason that I did the big chop, because coming back from that, I really couldn't come back from it. Like, my hair was never really was the same. Like, I saw a complete difference in just the life of my hair. And I was like, this is not going to be good.
So that makes a good point. I mean, when you're getting your hair braided, there are a few steps you should take, especially if you're getting it braided by someone new, or if you want to find someone new, we should be asking questions. We should be looking at other pictures, inspiration. We should be looking at even maybe like going down a rabbit hole and researching their clients and, you know, seeing how their client's hair has, you know, aged over the weeks, because some braiders, their braids last longer than others. We need to see how tight they're braiding, even calling a few clients, former clients or current clients, to see how their experience was. All that is important because, like Jess said, braids can do some severe damage if they're not done properly. And I think it's on us as clients to do the research before having someone in our head. And we think, oh, it's just braids. I'm going to get my homegirl to braid my hair. I'm going to do this. And I mean, we did that back in the day, but we didn't realize how much damage we were causing to our hair. I mean, it's really, really, really important. You had to do a big chop because your hair was so severely damaged from tight braids. And also, I think it's important that we know our hair texture and what our hair can handle. You know, some people are sensitive than others. And I don't think your perimeter is as sensitive as mine. So she must have really done some damage to your hair. Me knowing that my edges are sensitive and they will break off easily, I have to be careful with, you know, getting certain types of braids, even cornrows, paying attention to the braider and how they braid. And if your hair is too tight, let them know, like, they can redo it. And I've had that done a few times. If they're trying to braid your little baby hairs into a braid, tell them, no, can you please take that out, brush them to the side, and then they can like swoop it up at the end when they're done. Because you don't want your baby hairs braided into a braid. I know we used to do that back in the day with micros, and we'll talk about that.
Oh, Lord, have mercy.
That was a time. But everyone had them. But yeah, so I didn't know that. That's crazy.
Yeah.
Wild. Okay, so speaking of micros, I had I'd say it was a horror story, but it wasn't, how do I explain? It was a poor color choice. So I was in college and I got my hair braided. I got micros. I mean, back then, that's what we did, you know, human hair, micro braids. So I was, oh my gosh. This is why, just stay in your lane, people. This is why you stay in your lane and you do things that you're comfortable with. because I went and got micros, and this is not my first time getting micros. I used to get micros all the time. I went home, bought my hair. There was a African braiding hair studio down the street from my house. Went there. I had like regular like 1B hair. Again, human hair. What is it? Human hair? I forget if human hair. I don't think micros are human hair. It was some type of blend, but thought I was everything. Went back to school, and a friend of mine. So back in the day, they used to do that patch of like burgundy. Do you remember that? She did like no. She was okay. So she did like this patch of burgundy
with micros.
Hair. Yes, but it was really cute. It was really cute. I have a picture too. Hopefully, well, we might post it, but. The look on your face right now. And so I was like, oh, that's cute. I'm going to try that. So the next week I went back home. I live like an hour away. My home was an hour away from college. So I was like, I want to get what she got. And so I didn't know what color she got. Now what's burgundy? I know it's either BUR, but it's, what number is it?
It's BG.
BG. Right. Mm-hmm. So I didn't really, I was trying to match the color. I was trying to color match. And I ended, instead of burgundy, I ended up getting red. And it was just like.
Like a sweet red?
It was absolutely sweet red. Okay. That is exactly what that color was. Sweet red. And you know, so what I did was, I was like, okay, I'm going to take off half of my head. Take the braids out, right? I'm gonna take braids. I'm gonna go back to the studio and have her put this red in my hair. I'm gonna come back to college and they're gonna be like, oh, your hair is so cute. Okay, that was an epic fail because as she's putting, you know what? I don't know if I really saw the color, right? Like, I saw the color. I was like, okay, that looks close to burgundy. As she's putting the hair in my head, it's like flipping over, right? She's like, I'm just like, this looks very bright. Like, I don't think. This is kind of what I was going for. And then I took out too much hair. Like the person I was emulating had like a nice little like 5-6 rows back. I took out my entire front half of my hair. Yeah, I'll send you guys the picture. And so they did it or whatever.
I need to see this picture.
I came home and my parents were like, what the fuck did you do to your hair? I was like, I start crying. I was like, this is not what I was going for. I was trying to do like a cute, like deep burgundy look. This is not what I asked for. Like just saying all these things. I end up taking like half of the sides out. This whole thing. My mom helped me braid up the other half. It was just like, I mean, it was a fail because I was like, again, I should have just stayed in my lane. I didn't know what I was doing. I picked out the wrong color. I actually cried because I hated it so, so much. Ever since then, I never experimented with color until like 2 years ago because I just felt like that's it wasn't me. I didn't know what I was doing. Everyone hated it. Like even to this day, my grandfather, God rest his soul, a few years ago, he was like, you know, Brittany, you've always done good with your hair, but don't ever put that red mess in your hair. Freaking. That was 10 years ago. Like, what are you talking about? He's like, that just looks so ghetto. And I'm just like, okay. But I don't
Thanks,
know.
Grandpa.
Yeah, it actually scarred me. And so.
Oh my God. So no red hair for
me. No
Brittany
red for me. I will. You will never, like, ever see
I've never seen anything. You with red hair. Like, you burgundy, always do blondes.
I'll do, like, the sandy blonde with the 30, but I will never do, like, a burgundy or red or anything. I'm only experimenting with blonde. And so that segues into colors. Do your research. Figure out the colors that you want. Figure out how they look on your skin tone. Figure out the actual, like, what hair you're getting and what color that is. Because a lot of the shades vary between brands. Like, Rastafree's 27 is going to look different from Native's 27. I have Native hair in my hair. That's our line of PDBs. And Expression's 27 is going to look different also. So when you're researching colors, make sure you're actually inputting the brand that you're getting also, because it makes a huge difference. Make sure you're looking at color combos. Like a lot of people love like Beyonce's blonde lemonade braids. You know, obviously that was a mix of like 27s and 30s and 613.
613.
Yeah, all those. So you can have celebrity inspo and that's fine. Just make sure your braider understands the colors, understands how to blend them. Some blends. Mm-hmm.
That's what I was about to say.
Not all blends look alike.
They are not all created equally.
They are not all created equally. You can definitely blend things. You can have the same three colors. Say we're doing 27, 30, and 613. And you can have 10 different heads of hair, depending on how your braider blends the hair.
But when it's blended right, like Beyonce, like how you just... Oh. I love what she had those braids. Her, whatever Beyonce's stylist does to blend her hair.
Her stylist, I think her braider, she shops at the store. She's come in a few times. Yeah, I forget her name. But she's come in quite a few times. Blending is very important. And again, you need to talk with your braider and be very specific about colors, where you want them. Again, how you want them blended. If you want your hair tucked, tucked means that your natural hair is not showing. Sometimes, like if you can see, most of my hair is tucked. It's kind of hard to tuck it in the beginning, but as you go down the braid, you don't see my natural hair. Some braiders charge for that because it is an added step in the braid process. But there's so many things you can do with your hair. We talked about knotless. We talked about the boxes being big, the boxes being small, the braids being big, the braids being small. We've talked about tucking your hair. You can do cornrows. There's all kinds of styles. Oh my gosh, did you see Lori Harvey's new braid style? Did you see it, Jess?
Mm-mm.
Okay, so she debuted.
I'm not on Lori.
A look. I'm not
Let me see.
Like a stan or anything, but she debuted a look.
I used to
think
be,
at
but
New York Fashion Week. The other day, and it was really cute. It was like a Coil Ray.
Oh, like yeah. I saw it. It's her hair was short. Yeah.
Her hair was short. Right. And I think that was her natural hair. Rubber bands.
And it was like flipped. It was cute. Flipped.
Yeah. I thought it was different. Mm-hmm. I mean, there's just so many things you can do with braids. I'm going to ask you a very controversial question.
Okay.
How do you feel about our white counterparts rocking braids?
Putting you on the spot. I don't. I don't like it.
I don't like it
simply because why we just can't have stuff for ourselves. Because if you know about braids and where they come from and what the meaning behind it is, it's basically a nod to tribal African tribes from way back when. That's what they would use to basically they would, correct me if I'm wrong, this might be slave/African. They would basically map out the way to get out of slavery or whatever through braids. Is that right?
I think so. I think there's origins that date back to that. I think it was a way maybe for them to communicate with each other, a way for tribes and different cultures to express themselves.
Also to know which tribe, certain tribes do certain styles of braids. So you would be able to be like, oh, that woman is from such and such tribe. Or like, it's just something that's for us. Like if you're Black, if you're African-American, Afro, whatever, you know and understand the symbolism of braids. And braids is a whole thing. It's, you have to know how to take care of braids. You have to know... Mm-hmm. what you're getting them for. And if our white counterparts are getting braids because they just want to be down with the culture, it's like, it's more than that to us. It's more, we do it more for our culture than for you to come in and
Right.
Take it as your own.
And it's like the purpose of our braids, all right? Like we said in the beginning, we kind of do it for like a protective style. So we don't have to wake up every morning and do our hair. We have different reasons.
Right.
I feel like sometimes people just do it just to like be cool and fit in. Side note, I think I'm gonna edit this out though. I don't think I want to put it in the podcast.
Me either. Cause I was like,
yeah. I don't think I want to put it in the podcast. Abby, sorry. Okay, I'm gonna go into
because it is a very,
it's very controversial.
It's very controversial,
and I feel
and
like
my white friend listened to it, and I don't want her to be like, well, fuck. Yeah, it's a very controversial because we like it is like we do. Yeah, okay. Where are we going now?
Okay, I'm gonna go into braid maintenance. So,
okay,
How long should we our braids last? What should we be putting in our hair? How should we be taking care of it at night, in the shower? What we shouldn't be doing with our braids, all that. So we're at the 30 mark. Jess, let's go into braid maintenance. So we have all these different types of braids. We have box braids. We have cornrows. We have, what else do we have? Is that it? I mean, in terms of just like
passion twist, like crochet.
We can say crochet.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
We have, I think those are the, like the main types though.
Mm-hmm.
But we can get into styles and all that, but maintenance, it kind of goes, the type of maintenance is more for, we'll talk about the maintenance for like box braids since they're the most popular. And I think they require the most maintenance.
Mm-hmm.
You know, so for me, I'd say making sure like your scalp is moisturized, oiled down. I like to do a little spray oil in my hair a few times a week just to keep it moisturized. You don't want your hair being dry. And I mean, your natural hair. You don't want your natural hair.
Because it gets itchy.
Yeah, it can get itchy. It can get flaky. And then also the dryness succumbs to that tension and you can develop breakage. And that's what we do not want. We have braids in our hair for a reason, again, as a protective style, to keep our natural hair healthy. So we got to make sure we're taking care of our natural hair while our braids are in. Okay. Your braids should not be in your hair more than 4 to 6 weeks.
Absolutely. I thought you were going to say longer than that.
No.
Because you always read me for filth.
Yeah. Just
when I'm like, this shit got to come out.
Off
I'm done.
After 2 weeks. No, not
that. I'm done. No, I don't.
Yes.
I try to push it at least five. Try to go at least five.
Okay.
Because I'm not paying all this money for this.
Yeah. No, it's true. I mean, one, most braids nowadays are expensive. They are an investment and you want to get the most out of it. And some people keep their braids in shorter. I mean, that's fine. Do you? But your braids do not need to be in your hair. Those same braids do not need to be in your hair for 3 months. That is horrible. That's nasty. I don't care how much you're washing it. And it doesn't look good. After a certain time, you know, your hair will actually start to lock because it's been in that style for so long and there's no manipulation with it. So unless you're trying to grow locks, your braids should not be in your hair more than 4 to 6 weeks. Some people can stretch it to 8, which is fine. But I'm usually a 6 week girl. By week 6, I'm usually taking it out, especially because I have scalp issues and those start flaring up around that time.
Yeah.
So we should make sure we're moisturizing our hair. Some people like to put gel on their braids, maybe to lay down the flyaways. I think that's perfectly fine. In terms of,
I use mousse.
I was gonna say mousse is also good, especially if you have ends that are out. The mousse helps reduce the frizz. So I love that. Okay, so we have a really great brand at the store, Girl and Hair. It's a really great braid maintenance, lock maintenance, protective style maintenance hair care brand. And I mentioned them because I'm going to segue into washing our braids. They have some really great products that help keep our braids clean and smelling good and fresh. But what I love about them is like the applicator has like a nozzle where you can apply the product directly onto your scalp. And they have like shampoo, conditioner, like an ACV cleanse, which I love. Like I said, I have really bad scalp issues. So the ACV cleanse really cleanses my scalp, balances out that pH, and leaves it smelling fresh and clean. Some people wash their braids once a week. I'm more of like twice, well, every 2 weeks is more of what I like to do. But I get in there with the scalp cleanser, the conditioner. I put some leave-in in there. I don't scrub my braids. I'll massage my scalp and everything. But I'm like actively like rubbing my braids like with some type of soap, meaning shampoo, just to get out any type of dirt and buildup that may accumulate in the actual braids. Because it's important because braids can start stinking, which is also a reason why you should make sure you dry your braids. If you're air drying it, that's fine. Just after you wash it, I do not recommend putting it up. I recommend leaving it out and make sure that, leaving it down and make sure it dries completely, because if it doesn't, that's what leads to the smell. And that's moisture that's trapped in there with no oxygen, no air, no way to breathe. And it's a bad combo. So make sure you guys are washing your braids. There's tons of great YouTube videos out there on how to wash your braids, maintain your braids. One of the things I like to do after I wash my braids, I dry it. I'll blow dry it first. So I'll blow dry my my roots to make sure that they're dry. I walk around most of the time with a towel around my hair. And then I like to lay my edges down. So I'll get some edge control, brush my edges up, tie it down after it's completely dry, of course. And it's like new. Honestly, like washing the braids doesn't really mess them up too much. It depends on how aggressive you are when you're washing them. But I think the point I'm trying to drive home is just to make sure you wash your braids because they can stink. It's gross.
Yes. Or some type of dry shampoo. Something.
I don't use dry shampoo a lot, but it is effective. I've heard of people using it.
I use it. Oh, you like it? I rarely wash.
How do you? So what do you do?
I just I focus it more so on my actual scalp, and I make sure not to be too close to it because it still has that white cast, or you can see it.
So yeah, how do you get rid of that? Black,
The white cast,
yeah.
Fresh it out. The last time I did it, Alexis was like, why do you have that so close to your head? I was like, first of all, so aggressive. Leave me alone. But no, it does leave a cast if it's too close to your head. That's the only time that I use the recommended inches away from your head.
Right.
You actually read the directions so that it doesn't leave it. If you're far enough away from your scalp, then you won't have that white cast over it at all. So I more often than not use dry shampoo versus washing them, but I might wash this set because my scalp has been itching.
Really?
Yes. I don't know what. Me and my sister have been having dry scalp issues with this set of braids. And I don't know if we've gotten braids too often this year and our scalp is like, girl, I need a break. But yeah, our heads have been itching. So definitely washing your braids and using some type of oil. My favorite type of oil is the island oil from
it's so good. We use that
Jamaican mango.
I
don't know if anybody can go to this mental space with me and like after you've done they put that oil on your scalp, I swear that is the best feeling in the world. And it doesn't hit
the back of your head.
It does not hit the same way at home that it does when you're in that chair because you got the wet braids, the mousse, and then they put the, oh my God, it feels so good.
I know.
So good.
I know, I love
anything
that.
Anything with a dropper applicator that I can really get in there.
Get in the scalp. And it's
get
so
that
good.
Oil in there is so good.
Yeah. Ooh. That's so, like, let's list off some of our favorite products. So you said the Island Oil by yes. Jamaican Black Castor Oil.
Yes.
And no, Jamaica, it's by Jamaica Mango Lime. We'll put these products in the show notes also for you guys listening. So yeah, that's one of my favorites. I know I love the Shine and Jam braid stuff to actually braid the hair and like slick my edges down. I use that a lot.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
What's it called? It's braid better.
Shine and Jam, the extra hole,
the red one,
the yellow one. And then
like
the red
one
is met. I like both of
okay.
them. Magic Fingers.
And, that's what I'm saying. Yeah.
Yeah. Magic Fingers and Shine and Jam, the yellow extra hold. I personally like Black Panther when my hair is being braided.
Okay. I've got it done
holds,
with this one. Yeah. That's what Tammy was
I think
was
it
saying.
Holds
it
better.
It looks better. Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
So Black Panther Edge Control with a mix of Shine and Jam to braid. Also to lay your edges. I know we love the Baby Tress Edge Brush to lay our edges. Mm-hmm. That's always my go-to. And then I'll put like a silk or satin scarf around my edges to tie it down at night. Some of my other favorite products is the Magic Fingers Mousse to put over my braids. I like a good oil sheen every now and then because I love the way it feels when I spray it on my braids. So I'll do oil sheen. I'll do the Girl in Hair products that I was mentioning earlier, the whole system that they have. It's like a cleanser, a ACV rinse, a conditioner, and a leave-in conditioner, and a moisturizer. I use all of them. I love, obviously we get braids when we're traveling, and they have a cute little mini size travel version of all the products of the system. So I'm always bringing that with me when I travel. So I love that. I tie my braids down at night. I use a satin scarf. So usually what I do is I just tie it down with a satin scarf and I let them hang. In addition to that, when I'm taking a shower, I'll do the same thing, but then I'll roll it up and then put like a shower cap over it so they're not falling. And then one good tip, I pull my hair back a lot. Oh my gosh, my baby Zeus has been pulling my braids since I got home yesterday. So now when I'm home, I have to pull it back. And so I hate like the indentions or the creases that hair ties cause, normal hair ties. Mm-hmm. So I use the spiral hair ties whenever I have braids, when I pull it back, because once you take it out, it doesn't leave that crease in your hair. So, I think we still sell some of those at the store too, but, I think those are all my favorite products, and that's kind of what I use to maintain my box braids. Do you have any additions?
We forgot to say, edge booster, Style Factor.
Oh, you use Style Factor?
I use Style Factor to lay my edges. The one that's the pomade. It just works wonders on my little baby hairs. That's the only thing these days that keeps my hair laid all day is Style Factor Edge Booster.
I find that people have to switch back and forth between products because once
you get used to a certain product, your
hair stops cooperating and then you got to try something else.
Yeah.
So for me right now,
it's kind of annoying.
Yeah. It's the Shine and Jam. It's the Black Panther. But yeah. How do you tie your hair down at night?
Poof. Lord have mercy.
Do you leave it up or do you leave it down?
So I used to just leave it down and put a bonnet on.
Okay.
But I found that my ends would start looking matted quicker than what I would like. So okay. I'm taking a page
because
out
like
of my sister's book.
The look. You like the perfect, non-messy,
yes.
uniform look.
Yes.
I'm sure our audience is seeing a theme now with you.
So now what I do is I wear them. When I go to sleep, I put them in a loose like bun, like how they are on my head right now. And I put my silk satin scarf on. Now, I am not the most eloquent sleeper. So this bun by the morning time is out with no scarf on. So I just wake up and my braids are kind of everywhere. It works.
We gotta get you one of those bonnets that that ties.
Don't move.
Yeah.
It still gotta be cute. I feel like those aren't cute.
They're not cute.
But bonnets themselves are just not cute. Bonnets just, at least I feel like with my satin scarf on, it has like a little design to it.
Right. It's cute. Oh, you can make it cute.
Where did she go? Oh, Lord. Well, uh-oh. It has a design to it. Yeah, I really like the scarf, but I don't know what I'm supposed to do right now because Brittany's gone. She just popped out. Like, where did you go? Where did you go? That's a classic scene off of Clueless. That's the only thing that I know from the course.
The thing about this is, I don't know where we left off. It's just going to come back, make it out. Let's see what it says on her end.
Hello.
What's on your computer?
Me?
Just you?
Mm-hmm.
You don't see me?
You don't see me? Mm-mm.
Okay, so
stop.
What does your recording say?
What do you mean?
Like,
it says
the recording overview. What does it say right now? Episode
like the
six.
Minutes? What's talking about? Okay.
And the minutes?
It says 47:12.
Okay, so stop it. Is it stopped on your end? No.
I just stopped it.
Okay, so stop it and let's see if it uploads. And then we'll start again, but I got to see where we left off.
All right, it says upload complete.
That says upload. Okay, so I'm going to get out real quick. Hold on. I'm going to end meeting.